Members, members, the Right Honourable the Lord Mayor. Meeting of the City of Adelaide on Tuesday, 31st of January 2017. The Lord Mayor is in the chair.
Adelaide City Council acknowledges that we are meeting on the traditional country of the Kaurna people of the Adelaide Plains and pays respect to elders past and present. We recognise and respect their cultural heritage, beliefs and relationship with the land. We acknowledge they are of continuing importance to the Kaurna people living today. Council acknowledges the vision of Colonel William Light in determining the site for Adelaide and the design of the city with its six squares and surrounding belt of continuous parklands, which is recognised on the National Heritage List as one of the greatest examples of Australia's planning heritage.
This council public meeting will be streamed live and recorded for publishing to the internet. Please note that an audio and visual recording is taken of this meeting. This means that your presence at and any contribution you make to the meeting may be collected, used, disclosed or published publicly by council, including transferring outside of Australia. Please note also that a photographer from Ing Daily will be present tonight for file photographs.
We'll all remain standing in silence in memory of those that gave their lives in defence of their country, at sea, on land and in the air. Thank you, members.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we ask your blessing upon the works of the City of Adelaide. Direct and prosper its deliberations to the advancement of your glory and the true welfare of the people of this city. Amen.
Please be seated. Members, welcome to 2017. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the media, welcome. Nice to see you for another year ahead. Members, I'll start us off with apologies and leaves of absence. We have a full complement other than Councillor Alexantic, who has an apology for this evening's meeting. And I'll take us then on to item six in our agenda, which is confirmation of the minutes from our council meeting held on the 13th of December 2016, and also, members, a special meeting of council which was held the night before on the Monday, which was on the 12th of December 2016. So, members, the minutes for both of those meetings were distributed to you. One of those meetings was a confidential meeting held on the Monday prior to the regular Tuesday meeting, members. The minutes of both were distributed to you on the 16th of December. So, recognising that we had two meetings, members, could I please have someone move the minutes of both? Councillor Wilkinson, thank you. Seconded by Councillor Abiyard. Any questions, queries or comments, members? Those in favour of adopting the minutes? Those against will adopt the minutes for both of those meetings. Thank you very much, members. Item seven on your agenda, which is public forum or deputation, of which we have nil. Petitions on item eight on your agenda, members, we have nil, so I will take you on to item nine, which is advice from the Adelaide Parklands Authority and reports from other committees, and again, we have nil. So, members, we go to Lord Mayor's report. Before I do, I'd just like to extend thanks to CEO Administration on behalf of, we have a new format for our council papers, and I've had various comments from numerous members that it's a very workable format, so I'd like to extend thanks to our CEO and administration for adopting a new format in terms of the presentation of our papers, which I'm sure that our members and the media and the general public will appreciate. They certainly have a very congruent flow about them. Members, Lord Mayor's verbal report. dated today, 31st of January 2017. Again, welcome to the first meeting of the new calendar year for Council. I hope everyone had a refreshing break, spent time with family and friends. I'd like to thank Deputy Lord Mayor Megan Hender for undertaking the role of Acting Lord Mayor while I was on leave. Much appreciated, Deputy Lord Mayor. Members, on Christmas Day, the Lady Mayor and I attended several events, including serving breakfast at the Hutt Street Centre and at the Salvation Army Kitchen on Perry Street. We also attended an Adelaide City Council community-sponsored event called Waifs and Strays, which is a morning tea held at the Southwest Community Centre every year, a very popular event and a very good event. We also attended Australian Angels for the Homeless Dinner in the Pilgrim Meeting Hall, with Council donating the usage of that room on that day, being Christmas Day. On December the 28th, the Lady Maris and I attended the Proclamation Day event at the City of Holdfast Bay, commemorating the 180th anniversary of Governor Hindmarsh and the reading of the proclamation document under the old gum tree. 31st of December, I attended the City of Adelaide's New Year's Eve celebration, along with many of the elected members, and I think you'd agree, members, it was a terrific event. So well done to the CEO and administration for really lifting that event. And I can see members nodding about that. It was very, very well received. And I don't think we've had official numbers reported, CEO, but I would suggest we probably had a record at that event on that night. It seemed to be substantially bigger than other years. So thank you and well done. And well done to the events team. Also had the great honour of attending very recently the Australia Day Parade and the Australia Day Concert. Well done to our councillor, Councillor Hussam Abiyad, who is the chair of the Australia Day Council, South Australia, on a terrific event. Congratulations and well done. We know how much work that goes into. And also around that time, we swore in 53 new Australian citizens, which I always share with you members is a great honour of this job, is swearing in new citizens to Australia. Recently, the Lady Mayoress facilitated a fundraiser for a charity called MOSH, which is Minimisation of Suicide Harm, of which she is the patron, raised $2,500 from that event, which will go towards their outreach services. And on the weekend, Lady Mayoress and I attended the annual Navy Week commemorative church service at Christ Church in North Adelaide. We've attended various Chinese New Year celebrations already. And I'm sure, members, you'll be engaging in many Chinese Lunar New Year celebrations over coming weeks, of which there's a multitude in the City of Adelaide. So, members, thank you. It's going to be a big year ahead, and I'm sure we're all recharged in order to get on with the job in which we're tasked. So could I please have a member move to adopt my verbal report? Thank you. Moved by Councillor Clarahan, seconded by Councillor Mullany. Those in favour of adopting? Carried. Thank you very much, members. I take you to councillors' reports. Members, they're noted on page 4 of your papers. Does members, anyone want to speak to theirs? Councillor Mullany, you'd like to move? Any comments about them? Seconded by Deputy Lord Mayor. Not seconding, seconded by Councillor Abiyad. Members, would anyone like to speak to reports? Thank you, Deputy Lord Mayor.
Just very quickly, Lord Mayor, I just need to make a correction or an amendment to the report because I was unable to attend the Brighton Sculpture event because of another obligation that I had on Friday, I think Friday, no, Monday, yesterday, and this report was prepared prior to that and in the expectation that I'd get there. So with that amendment, I'm happy to support that.
Thank you, noted. I'm sure that administration will duly reflect that in the records, Deputy Lord Mayor. Members, any further queries about any events you've attended on behalf of Council during the said period? No. Those in favour of adopting the councillor's reports, those against, we carry. Thank you very much, members. Appreciate it. Members, noting also that various changes for 2017 now include a 3-minute speaking time for members on the floor associated with matters on the agenda or any council agenda. Should you wish to extend that, you would then need to look to me in order for me to seek leave from the room in order to get a majority consensus for you to get another 2 minutes, not 10. So we are all aware of those new provisions which we duly adopted late last year. Which takes me on, members, to item 12 on the agenda, which is item 12.1, which is the local nuisance and litter control delegations, page 6 in your papers. Members, I will look for a mover, if I can, please. Councillor Corbell, seconded by Councillor Abiyad. Councillor Corbell, would you wish to speak to this matter? Councillor Abiyad, would you wish to speak to this matter? Members, to the floor, any debate? Councillor Corbell to sum up. Summed up, members, I'm going to put this right back to you for adoption. Those in favour? Those against? We carry that item 12.1, which takes us on to 12.2, which is the Minister's Code for Existing Building, page 19 on your papers, moved by Councillor Wilkinson, seconded by Councillor Abiyard. Councillor Wilkinson, would you wish to speak to this matter?
Yes. On this score, I would commend Minister John Rao. And working in the building industry and having had experience with how the way that the building code and is implemented is basically causing the sterilisation of buildings. And theoretically, there are the advantages of every building being upgraded to modern building standards, but it specifically says that it'll be upgraded not necessarily to new building standards, because it's not viable and it doesn't happen, and buildings just get left to rot. And a lot of those buildings are heritage buildings or buildings that should be heritage buildings, which if this all comes to pass, will enable greater flexibility to enable these buildings to be used. So on this score, I really commend John Rao for actually doing a good thing for the city to enable these buildings to be utilised, and because the current regime isn't serving anyone's interest.
Thank you, Councillor Wilkinson. Councillor Abiyard, you seconded the motion. Members to the floor, any debate about this matter? Deputy Lord Mayor.
I've got a question, Lord Mayor. Look, I support the motion, I support the code, and as Councillor Wilkinson said, this is an issue that's going to really help with adaptive reuse of you know, precious heritage buildings. What's not to like about that? But on paragraph 18, we're told by our administration that the code uses mandatory and discretionary language, which will need revision before publication. So I'm just wondering, do we need to put that in our motion, or is that going to be picked up somehow, or is that going to be part of our feedback, or how is that going to be addressed?
I'll refer that through our CEO, DLM.
Claire Mocker, thanks.
Through the presiding member, in the attachment, what we provided is clarification where we prefer to see stronger language used.
Does that answer your question, Deputy Lord Mayor?
In part, so I think I understand.
Members, any further debate? Councillor Wilkinson to sum up.
Summed up.
Members, those in favour? Those against? We carry that item, which is 12.2, Minister's Code for Existing Buildings. Members, I take you on to item 12.3, which is Land Management Agreement, McKinnon Parade, page 83 of your papers. Can I have a mover, please, members? Councillor Moran, thank you. Do I have a seconder for the purposes of the debate, members? Councillor Vershaw, Councillor Moran, would you like to speak to this matter? Councillor Vershaw. Okay, members of the floor. Councillor Lane, you got a question? Okay. Councillor Wilkinson.
I have looked.
Sorry, Councillor Wilkinson, I may not have seen Councillor Moran, who is the mover. I apologise.
Yes, Councillor Moran, could you? Is it okay for the DAP members to be here for this? I'd ask advice from administration.
We'll take governance advice on that. The answer is yes.
Members, can I indicate for those council members who are members of the Development Assessment Panel to also give consideration to the DAP Code of Conduct and its requirements? So whilst you are able to remain in the chamber for purposes of voting, you do need to be conscious of the input that you have in speaking and through the debate in terms of the DAP Code of Conduct. Code of conduct, i.e. judging an application, making comments around the merit or not of an application, being perceived to have a view around the application.
An application? But it's a land, it's not an application at this stage.
It's not at this point, but it will be. And what you may say at this point could be determined at the time of the panel that you have a preconceived view.
So if we mention in debate anything about the upcoming development, that would be contrary. Okay.
Yes, absolutely.
Do Does that assist those members that sit on the DAP panel? It does. Okay, Councillor Abiyad. Councillor Maloney did have her hand up.
I just want to declare a potential conflict of interest on this, and I prefer to exit just in case things progress, that's all.
Certainly, Councillor Abiyad, thank you for doing so. Councillor Maloney.
Thanks. Well, I don't have a question. I was just sharing some intel with my fellow DAP members.
Thanks, Councillor. Members, I'm going to go to Councillor Wilkinson. The floor is yours.
Yes. Now, having looked at the report and the proposal, and having been around within the planning department at the time when the land management was put in place, there has to be good reason to deviate from the land management agreement, which was in place. It was in place at the time that this property was purchased by the current owners. So they bought knowing what those requirements were. And whilst I acknowledge there has been some discretion given to aspects of the land management agreement for other properties along this strip, in my view, and I'm not a member of the DAP, so I can speak freely on the merits of the proposal, other proposals have exhibited extremely high merit and good rationale for departing from the provisions of the land management agreement. And having seen this proposal, I fail to see any particular merit that justifies us setting aside the land management agreements in place at the time that they purchased the and so I'd actually be moving an amendment that on the basis that the proposal doesn't lack merit to justify. If they came back with some more meritorious proposal, they could justify deviation, they have a different view, but as it stands, what's being put forward, I don't consider merits departing from the land management agreement. And I think it's pointless having a land management agreement if even a very non-meritorious, in my personal opinion, proposal is then allowed to sidestep the land management agreement. So I'd move amendment that we not, we add the word not, agree to varying the land management agreement.
So Councillor Wilkinson, you are moving an amendment. Could you please be a little more prescriptive in terms of what section of the recommendation you are moving the amendment, please?
Just inserting the word not, basically, does not work. Oh, I'm happy to take advice on Councillor Moran's suggestion.
It's a direct negative to the motion, so Councillor Wilkinson, quite rightly, will vote against it.
Then the land management agreement stands. Okay, in which case I think that'll be
sufficient. I'll get advice on your question, yep. Councillor Abiyad. Councillor Wilkinson, I apologise, for the purposes of informing the debate. CEO.
Through you, Lord Mayor. It is true, it is a direct negative, and therefore if the motion was put as it is and it was voted down, it would be successful, so there wouldn't be no need to have the amendment anyway. So.
Okay, in which case I'll be voting against it, not needing to seek a seconder, and encourage other members to sort of have listened to what I said and encourage a better, and which would enable the administration to negotiate a better outcome for the site than it's currently put forward.
Thank you, Councillor Wilkinson. There's our 3-minute bell. Now, Councillor Moran, you put your hand up earlier, followed by Councillor Clearyhand.
I'd like to speak to the motion that I move. Look, as we've been told, the merit or non-merit of this building is I cannot discuss and have not taken into account. The land management change is entirely meritorious. Every building here has been altered, and I think that breaks the rules or shatters the rules more than doing it up front. We've done it actually when the developer has brought in the building, and which is higher, wider, denser, etc. And then we've said, and I can speak experience on that, that the land management agreement and the size of the blocks were very small. It's a bit like the Le Cornu site. They're almost impossible to, with the price that these were charged for parkland frontage. We were sympathetic, and I think Councillor Wilkinson was there too, we were sympathetic with the overdevelopment of these sites.
because of the very small land divisions. So I'm quite comfortable with this. I'm not going to say I'm comfortable with the replacement building because we're not allowed to talk about that here. And there's probably many a change to happen to that design before we actually see it. I'm assuming that this is probably just an indicator.
Councillor Moran, for the benefit of your fellow members, you are comfortable with the recommendation as it stands. Is that what you're sharing with your members? Thank you. Now I've got Councillor Clerahan followed by Councillor Martin. Councillor Clerahan, floor
is yours. Thank you, Lord Mayor. Look, I just wanted to draw attention to paragraph 5 on page 85, and really it backs up the comments made by Councillor Moran. The adjoining properties that were also subject to land management agreements have had their or councillors agreed to waive compliance for them, and that in fact we've waived compliance for this particular site on a previous occasion. However, our own development assessment panel chose not to approve it, or it was refused in the court, and I think we ought to let that process take its path again. That in principle we ought to allow to waive the compliance with the land management agreement and allow the assessment process to determine what is and what isn't appropriate on that site and within its context.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Martin.
Yeah, thank you, Lord Mayor. Look, I endorse the arguments that Councillor Wilkinson has put forward. The nub of the argument, as I understand it, is that while at 5 and 7 in the discussion paper, the administration observes that the height, the scale, the bulk, the setbacks are all okay, I formed the view in meetings that I had, or a meeting I had with Councillor Wilkinson and the administration, that it feels that the structure itself may not be ideal. That is to say that it is not of the same merit as the structures erected on other blocks or lots.
Point taken, Councillor Moran, but Councillor Martin is not a DAP member. He can have this discussion. Please continue, Councillor.
Lord Mayor, may I just say that this is the problem with the conflict of interest provisions, because the debate is being shaped by the conflicts of interest of members of DAP and other organisations within council. That is a problem for council. That is not a problem for me as a speaker. I am addressing the issue, and intertwined in this issue is an issue of design. It's central to the point that Councillor Wilkinson is making. And the point of the administration, as I understand it in our meeting, is that it may well be that there is some merit in council sending a message to the applicant for the variation of the land management agreement that this structure may not be what we're looking for. Look, this is a really crucial part of Adelaide. It is part of the dress circle of Adelaide and North Adelaide overlooking the parklands. The structure that's proposed in the plans, and there's no getting away from it, the plans are in here. These are the plans that I assume are going to go to DAP. The plans delineate a structure that does not have the same architectural merit of the buildings surrounding it. That is the nub of the issue. It's not tickety-boo in terms of the existing structures. Now, a decision to defer this would, as Councillor Wilkinson proposed, enable the administration to go back to the proponent and say, look, can we talk? And that is the intention, I think, of Councillor Wilkinson's proposal, as I understand it, and I endorse that entirely. That's a reasonable approach. Now, how council deals with the conflict of interest for DAP members is another matter.
Thank you, Councillor Martin. Noting that Councillor Wilkinson is simply voting against the recommendation, not moving to defer the matter, he's just voting against it. That was what he said.
I understand, Lord Mayor, but that's effectively what happens.
Understood. Members, Councillor Moran, you are summing up in the absence of any further debate.
To sum up, I can assure Councillor Martin that DAP, Council DAP, is a very rigorous process, and that's the time to talk about the building. This council are not planning assessors, building assessors, and the appropriate time to look at the building is then. That's nothing to do with the land management agreement.
Members, I put this for your consideration. Those in favour of the recommendation? Those against? The recommendation is carried. Thank you, members. If we can invite Councillor Abiyad back into the chamber, please. Members, we have a quorum. Councillor Abiyad has been advised, so I will keep the meeting moving. Members, we move on to part of our 12.3, of course, was the noting that there were no emerging key risks. So I'll take you on to item 13, which is questions on notice on your agenda. We have a question on notice from Councillor Martin regarding carbon neutral, page 95 of your papers. Members, I will read the response to you in answer to Councillor Martin's question. Councillor Martin, do you wish to read your question or would you like your fellow members to take that as noted? Thank you, Councillor. The answer to Councillor Martin's question, members, is annual targets for the aforementioned activities currently do not exist. The City of Adelaide 2016 to 2020 strategic plan sets an agreed target that city carbon emissions will be reduced by 35% from the 2006-2007 baseline by 2020. Council and contractor vehicles and machinery having low to zero emissions will be critical to the city achieving this 35% target. The strategic plan further cites by June 2017, council will complete a procurement plan for all council vehicles to be low or zero emissions, and our procurement practices will reasonably require the environmental track record and or credentials of suppliers and estimates of carbon emissions of products and services. Council's administration is currently investigating the cost effectiveness and feasibility of delivering priority actions within Council's operations by 2020 under each of the carbon reduction pathways defined in Carbon Neutral Action Plan 2016 to 2021 as endorsed by Council in September 2016, being 1, energy efficient built form, 2, zero emissions transport, 3, towards 100% renewable energy, 4, reduce emissions from waste and water, and 5, offset carbon emissions. Investigations will include but will not be limited to 1, low and zero emission vehicles for Council's fleet, comprising of light and heavy vehicles, 2, procurement policy for selecting alternatives to carbon intensive goods and services, and 3, reducing waste disposal to landfill. Based upon these investigations and workshop consultations with Council, a draft Carbon Neutral Council Roadmap 2017 to 2020, otherwise known as the Roadmap, with costed carbon reduction pathways will be prepared for Council's consideration before the end of the first quarter of 2017-2018. The draft roadmap will consider annual and overall targets for priority emission sources within Council's operations that can cost effectively and reasonably be reduced within the 2020 target timeframe. So members, I'll just ask someone to move that as noted in terms of that response. Councillor Corbell, Councillor Clarahan, those in favour for noting that response. Thank you, members. Thank you, Councillor Martin, for your question. Members, we now go to item 14 on your agenda, which is questions without notice. Members, do I have any questions without notice on the floor? Councillor Corbell, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. Just a question about the local nuisance and litter control newly enacted act. Last year in November, I moved a motion about cigarette butts in the public realm. And I'm interested to know from the administration when we're going to be receiving an update on that and how the enacted act now will then feed into that body of work. And the provisions, specifically the provisions which are provided for as tools of enforcement.
Thank you, Councillor Corbell. Through our CEO.
Clare Mockham, thanks.
Through the presiding member, We were waiting for the legislation to become enacted, which from a litter perspective, it does in February. And we're on track to meet the obligations that you asked us to consider, in particular the cigarette butt element of your original motion. I'm happy to provide an update in terms of the exact date of when we'll be able to progress that and circulate that to members out of session.
That answers your question, Councillor Corbell. Thanks, Councillor. Thank you, Claire. Members, any further questions without notice? In absence of further questions, I'll move you to motions without notice. Any motions without notice, members? There aren't. So I'll take you to item 15 on your agenda papers, which is motions on notice. Councillor Martin, motion on notice regarding strategic approach workshop, page 96 of your papers. Councillor Martin, the floor is yours.
I need a seconder, Lord Mayor.
Councillor Abiyad, your seconder.
Thank you. Is it okay if I accept it as read? Yes?
That's fine, Councillor. Members?
Lord Mayor, look, this is a very straightforward proposal. It's designed to enhance the experience of developers and entrepreneurs when dealing with Adelaide City Council, and also to enhance the reputation of this city as being one with whom it's a pleasure to do business. One hears from time to time horror stories where property developers have experienced problems in the past. And I did speak with several business people late last year who had tales of woe. But those stories were largely historical. And I observe that because council has come a long way in the past few years. But as one businessman said to me late last year, there's always room for improvement. And he said, we as developers would like the opportunity to share our perspective to help council streamline its processes. Now, he suggested, and I've mirrored that here, an informal process, an occasion where elected members and senior executives could meet with developers and entrepreneurs and share their experiences and listen to what they have to say about the experience in Adelaide, but also the experiences they've had in other places, because they believe, I understand, that the experiences in other cities such as Melbourne are relevant to the experience in Adelaide. And in this way, council would be in a much better position to iron out any wrinkles that may exist in the existing system and to come up with possible solutions. Now, others with whom I've shared the idea, and I did discuss it widely, we're all enthusiastic about it, and I thank you, Lord Mayor, for your enthusiasm for the proposal, and the CEO also having remarked to me the other night that this was something he was right behind. This, members, is meant to be a positive initiative, one from which we as elected members will get to hear directly from the people on whom we rely for this city's prosperity, and a proposal that will, I hope, also at the same time cement our reputation as one of the councils that listens and is prepared always to listen to its stakeholders. And so, therefore, I ask simply for your support.
Thank you, Councillor Martin. Councillor Abiyad, you seconded it. Were you to speak to it?
Just briefly, Lord Mayor, thank you, Councillor Martin. And just possibly, if this may be able to be considered as part of our business engagement forum, where we can invite members of the public or businesses that want to provide some feedback, or maybe another avenue, but I just thought I'd note that just in case it wasn't taken into consideration.
Thank you, Councillor Abiyad. Members, Deputy Lord Mayor, followed by Councillor Wilkinson.
Look, I support this. I think it's a great initiative. I did note that Councillor Martin, in his remarks, indicated that we want to hear from business owners and entrepreneurs, but the motion as put only refers to property owners. But I'm wondering whether Councillor Martin would be willing to vary the motion to extend it to business owners and entrepreneurs so that we hear from not just people who are property developers, but anyone who's trying to run businesses in the city?
Look,
or
I,
if there was a reason not to?
There was a reason. As it was explained to me, the problems experienced by the two groups are different problems. That is to say, a business owner will have a range of concerns, but they're on a different scale. Developers are generally much more concerned about regulations and legislation related to launching projects. But the point that that is raised...
Councillor Martin, I'm sorry, I'm not going to enable you to debate. You've had a request for a variation. It's been denied. You've been very given you a lot of latitude in explaining why. Members, Councillor Mullaney.
Thank you, Lord. Oh, I think Councillor Wilkinson was actually...
Apologise. Councillor Wilkinson's looking at me. Councillor Wilkinson followed by Councillor Mullaney. Councillor Wilkinson, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Councillor Mullaney. Lord Mayor, dealing with developers as clients, I know that developers want to have certainty when they purchase a property and they go in with their eyes wide open as to what they can and can't do. And often when one... I'm happy and to support the motion, it's good to get it out there and hear from people, but just bear in mind that when you hear people complaining about the red tape and the frustration they have with council, invariably if you look behind what they don't say to the people that they're complaining to is because they actually have knowingly not complying with the rules in place, which were in place at the time they purchased the property, and they're trying to overstep the mark. And that's why they're experiencing frustration. So they can often only blame themselves for give an inch, take a mile, for trying to take a mile. So sometimes and quite often people will complain about red tape and when what they're really trying to do is gain a windfall for themselves by overstepping the mark. That's my experience.
Councillor, are you speaking in favour or against the motion for the benefit of your fellow members?
I'm speaking in favour. I don't think there's any harm in doing this, but I'm just sort of sharing my experience of what's behind a lot of the purported complaints.
Understood, Councillor. Thank you. Councillor Mullaney.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. Look, I'll speak in favour and support the motion, but what I would like an outcome from this to be and the administration to take on notice is that this is what we should be doing all the time. It's not a one-off workshop. This is a constant communication we should be having with all the different stakeholders in our city. Obviously, the commercial property owners and developers are an important stakeholder. So I don't want it to be noted this is what we do, a one-off workshop, and there's a hero moment here. This is what we do every day, and I want that to be noted.
Thank you, Councillor Mullaney. Members, any further debate? Back to Councillor Martin to sum up.
Look, just very briefly, Lord Mayor, I acknowledge both Councillor Mullaney and Councillor Hinder's contributions. That, I hope, would be a consequence of what follows from this. And it may well be that there will be an opportunity to have discussions with other stakeholders, if not on one occasion, then on several others, or on a continuing basis. So I just ask members to support it on the basis that this may well lead to other outcomes.
Members, I put this before you. Those in favour? Those against? Motion carried. Thank you, Councillor Martin. Members, we now go to item 16, which is exclusion of the public. We have a number of matters, members, to debate in confidence, of which there are five. So I'd need an exclusion order for each of them, please, members. 17.2.1, which is a research project. Can I have a mover to move into confidence, please? Councillor Clearahan, seconded by Councillor Vershaw. Councillor Mullaney, you'd like to make a comment before I do the vote?
Just a quick question. I respect Cabinet in confidence, but I assume a research report with data will eventually be used and released in the future. Am I correct?
I can answer that, Councillor. Yes, it is. It's part of the motion whereby this will be then publicly released in due course once it's been debated by CCC. It's correct. Yep. Members, any debate about moving that item into confidence? I'll put that for your consideration. Those in favour? Those against? So we carry that item into confidence. 17.2.2, which is the appointment of a board director of the Vulnerable Management Authority. Can I have a mover to go into confidence? Councillor Clearahan, seconded by Councillor Abiyard. Any debate, members? Those in favour? Members, we're voting. Those in favour? Those against? We carry. 17.2.3, which is a matter regarding the pavilion, a parklands lease, to move into confidence. Those moved by Councillor Corbell, seconded by Councillor Mullaney. Those in favour, members? Those against? We move that into confidence. 17.2.4, Council Solutions Waterways Project. Can I have a mover, please? Councillor Mullaney, seconded by Councillor Slama. Any debate? No debate. To move into confidence, members? Thank you. We move into confidence. Item 17.2.5, assignment of a lease regarding 110 Perry Street. Moved by Councillor Mullany, seconded by Councillor Abiyard. Members voting to move into confidence, those in favour. Those against, we carry. So, ladies and gentlemen, can I ask that all members of the public and administration staff not related to these matters directly, can I please ask you to move from the chamber, and I thank you for your attendance. back into public, at which point in time we will recommence recording briefly. Thank you. Members, I formally declare this evening's meeting closed at 7:21 p.m. Thank you, members. Thank you, administration, for your contribution. Much appreciated. Meeting closed. Yeah.